Welcome back, everyone, to our third keynote session of the conference. We've had so many great speakers to help us become better leaders and people, and today's speakers are exactly that. On behalf of Team Innovate, we are excited to share with you our friends from Virtues Matter, who had a very special message for us today to wrap up our Innovate 2020 Community Awareness Challenge. But before we meet our speakers, let's take a moment to reflect on this experience. As we reflect on the Community Awareness Challenge, we see all the amazing things you members are doing. Through this project, we have become mental health advocates and are now on the front lines of this issue. This week, we as a collective have become the catalyst for change.
Before we kick off this session, on behalf of the Washington DECA State Officer Team, Olivia and I would like to thank all of you for your support and participation with this event. This week, we began to make a difference around this topic, but it does not end here. Continue to be using the language of virtues everywhere to spread positivity in your homes, schools, communities, and in the world. Thank you all for hashtag sharing the love, DECA.
And now, let's meet our keynote speakers. Yes, speakers, because there are two of them for this session. First, I'd like you to meet the Chief Enthusiast Officer for Virtues Matter, a passionate educator, speaker, author, coach, and consultant, author of The Heart of Education, bringing joy, meaning, and purpose back to teaching and learning. She was honored as Disney's 2005 Outstanding Elementary School Teacher of the Year, Educator of the Year for the National Association of Self-Esteem in 2009. The list of her honors and awards go on and on. Dara now spends her days working with her husband as the co-founder of Virtues Matter.
The Chief Everything Else Officer of Virtues Matter. A social entrepreneur, community builder, thought leader, and international speaker. He touches on a full-scale range of topics. He was previously director of Green America's Center for Sustainability Solutions. There, he worked to develop sustainable supply chains and drive systems. He was the co-founder of the Livability Project and founding director of Bethesda Green. Dave is now seen alongside his wife, Dara, as the co-founder of Virtues Matter. Please welcome the founders of Virtues Matter and our good friends, Dara and Dave Feldman.
Thank you so much, Zach, Olivia, and all of DECA. We are so honored. It is such a joy. And we'd be grateful if you would allow us to share our screen now. So as we do that, just want to honor everybody for your creativity, for your steadfastness, for your strength, for your resilience, and oh my goodness, so many more virtues that we have seen you all demonstrate over this past, oh my goodness, during COVID and everything else. It is really a joy and an honor. So this is not a sit and get. This is actually, we're going to invite you to engage. And so with that, we want to invite you to listen to one of your previous, I think, keynotes, a friend of ours, Andy Grammer. And in the chat box, please type things, people, places, ideas that you love.
Yeah, no, that says it all. So we'll see you on the other side of this. And if you want to move a little bit, we know it's early in the morning. We've had our couple cups of coffee already, so we're looking forward.
Dance along and sing it.
Fill in the chat box.
My mother was a sunshine soldier. Every day was a dream come true. She said that we were blessed by the breath deep inside us. She could make the colors in the sky turn blue. She said, honey, what you gonna do today? You're second guessing every single move you make. You're definitely gonna have some very hard days, but I'll be right here for you. And she said, before I go, there is one thing you should know.
Come on, everybody.
I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. 'Cause in the end, the love we taste got nothing on the love we make. So give love.
Maybe.
say you're gonna be a lot in a cold world. You got extra love pumping up in your veins. To my people feeling down, to my people feeling empty, I got so much of this love, I gotta give it away. Hey honey, what you gonna do today? You're second guessing every single move you make. You're definitely gonna have some very hard days, but I'll be right here for you. And she said before I go, there is one thing you should know. I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. 'Cause in the end, the love we taste got nothing on the love we make. So give love.
On repeat, it's so elementary. Just that 1 + 1 = 2. You sprinkle love, that equal 3. Love you, that's the remedy. Blind man, he
get
can
up and
see.
Move your you body, friend.
Up, I know the recipe. It's
get that enthusiasm going.
Down the avenue, they hate, I'm throwing a piece. That's my own reply. You know, I don't even try. Yeah, I give that love, I give that love. I know the reason why. Whoa.
I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. I give love to all of my people. All of my people need love. I give some. 'Cause in the end, the love we taste got nothing on the love we make. So give love. So give love. So give love.
Well, hello, everybody. Good morning. Hopefully, I woke up everybody a little bit. And what a pleasure to see Andy Grammer sing about sharing love and giving love. And I know that you've been sharing love this week and working on love. It's been so exciting for us to be part of this and working with you and DECA. So we want to start off by acknowledging all of you, first of all, for what has been one remarkable year on so many levels. Your perseverance in just pushing through and studying online, your unity coming together, putting this conference together, your idealism as entrepreneurs. Darren and I are going to share a little bit about our stories, about wanting to make a better world. That's really a lot of what entrepreneurship is. And it's been really remarkable. We've had an opportunity to work with a number of different teams on DECA already in pulling this together. And it's been a wonderful experience. I want to throw out a couple of thank yous. There are a couple of folks who really just shined. Lori Hairston, who's been involved with this from the beginning. It was her vision to bring us in and get involved with Virtues. She saw there's a real opportunity to connect. We see DECA as a great partner. And Roger Sargent, who's been just an absolutely wonderful individual, who actually was the one who I found introduced. He's an advisor and works across all of the other folks, including a new podcast that's coming out that we're working with around Virtues. So would you like to start and do a little bit of a mindful
moment? Well, I would, but there's some more. So I want to acknowledge each and every one of you on here for your creativity and your commitment and innovation. And also Zach and Olivia and all of the state officers who probably haven't slept for months and months and months, right? So we didn't want to say everybody's name because we were afraid that we would miss people. All of you, thank you so much for your generosity of service and idealism. So let's get started with a little mindful moment. This is not a sit and get. Just notice how you feel right now. Because we hope that by the end of our time together, you're going to feel like your spirits have been uplifted in addition to your toolboxes filled just a little bit more. So yesterday with the mental, or a couple of days ago, there was that focus on some mental health and mental awareness with Nathan. I'll share a little bit of my story in a little bit, but what research shows is that mindfulness and breath can really help us and to increase our serotonin, right? And we need that. And that when we have fun and we dance and we move, it increases our dopamine legally and for free, by the way.
Which is especially important when we're sitting on Zoom calls in front of a computer all day long. So kind of giving yourself that break and pace is really key.
And when we connect with one another, that increases our oxytocin. So we hope that you're going to be full of serotonin, dopamine, and oxytocin, in addition to strategies by the end of our time together. So I'd like to invite everybody to take 3 deep breaths, but I want to teach you just how to do it. You're going to inhale through your nose nice and deeply, and maybe inhaling love, hold, and then you're going to exhale as if you're blowing out a straw. And I want you to exhale peace. Your exhale is going to be longer than your inhale because you want to get rid of the toxins. So nice deep breath in, love, and hold it. Then exhale peace as if you're blowing out of a straw. We're going to do that together 3 times. Here we go. Inhaling love. And exhaling peace. Inhaling love. And exhaling peace. And one more time, inhaling love and exhaling peace. Just nod or clap or thumbs up if you're feeling just a little bit more relaxed than you did. Yep, or snap. Just 3 nice deep breaths. Okay, you can stop breathing. No, just kidding. Keep breathing. And anytime you feel you need a little more energy, do that. So before Dave and I get into the content, we always like to say it's connection before content. And we want to let you know a little bit about who we are and why we're even here. Because if you don't know who we are, you're probably not going to really be open to listening to us. So just a quick story to connect a little bit with Nathan. And unfortunately, I imagine many of you. Permission to be personal? Is that okay? All right. So when I was 5, I was sexually abused by a next door neighbor. And I was a babysitter and I didn't realize at the time that it wasn't my fault. And I ate to protect myself and to protect my feelings of shame. And then my mom had cancer in second grade when I was in second grade and she thought she was going to die. And she told me not to tell everybody. Do you know what 7-year-olds do? They tell everybody. So more shame. And then when I was in third grade, my mom started her alcoholism. And I was the heaviest kid in my elementary school. I was made fun of. They called me Bahama Mom. I was bullied. And my third grade teacher allowed me to stay in during recess. And she made me feel loved when I felt unlovable. And I knew ever since I was 8 years old, that I wanted to be a teacher because I wanted my students to know that they are loved just because. So I ended up growing up, okay, not really, but I got older. I became a teacher and my first husband actually had alcoholism as well. And he passed away homeless as a result of the disease. Dave and I have been married for 21 years. And so because of my trauma, I've been in 12-step programs. Al-Anon for families of alcoholics and OA for people with eating disorders. I've been free from binging, purging, and starving one day at a time by the grace of God for 23 and a half years. And I always felt that everybody could benefit from 12 steps. And then when I was honored as Disney's Elementary Teacher of the Year, I found out about the Virtues Project, which is 5 strategies for bringing out the best in ourselves and others. It's like a 12-step program, but you don't have to go through the drama and trauma to participate. But here's the secret, everybody. We all have our stuff, don't we? And when it's hard and we're in that chrysalis and it's dark and it's moist and it's scary and we have no idea what's happening, it's those virtues that you all have in you that's helping us to transform. And then we push out of that chrysalis. And do you know what happens if somebody pulls a butterfly out and helps them out of a chrysalis? They die. So it's really the struggle that helps us to grow and strengthen our virtues. And I would go back, I'll be 58 in 2 weeks. I would go back and go through everything that I've been through in order to be where I am today. And that's my wish and my prayer for you all. So that's just a little bit about why I do what I do. And this is all about healing and well-being and knowing ourselves.
Honey. Yeah. So my story is a little bit different. And as Dara had known from a very young age that she wanted to be a teacher, my direction, my passion was business from a very young age. My dad owned a beer, wine, deli store. I worked there starting when I was 12 years old. I had a lawn business. And I knew business was, it was what made me passionate. And when I was a kid, I had a big passion for the environment. And I didn't really kind of look at the two worlds intersecting at the time. But through a series of different jobs and careers, kind of the world came together. I've had a fascinating career, I think. And one of the jobs that I had was I was actually head of economic development at the British Embassy in Washington, D.C. And my role was to help U.S. companies set up in the U.K. and U.K. companies to do business over here. And in doing so, I started to appreciate the entrepreneur's journey, because my role was to help these businesses grow, and not only grow, but grow internationally. And I saw the struggles they had with their operations, their legal, their staffing, you know, just the challenges that big businesses have, which is the same as small businesses. And through that process, I started to look at how communities operate, and I went down a path of sustainability. And sustainability, from my perspective at the time, was the places where we live. How do we make it great? How do we make our places livable? How do we bring all the people together to be invested in their community? But the thing that's really interesting is sustainability is more than just about communities. It's also about who we are. How do we live sustainable lives? What we put into our bodies, both the food we eat, what we put into our heart, what we put into our minds. So all the things that we put in is about how we be sustainable, hence a lot of the work about the virtues, and also a sustainable business. And what's interesting about a business, and as many of you are seeing already, you can have the best product in the world. You can have marketing. You can have good culture. But if you don't have all of those, you don't have the finances, if you don't have every piece of your business operating and integrated and working systemically, any one piece will take your business down. So sustainability has been that kind of a thread that's carried through in my life in a lot of different ways. So what I would like to do is actually ask you each to put in the chat, every one of you, is think of an entrepreneur who has inspired you. Just the first name and last name. Just write down somebody. Take a moment to think about this. Write down somebody who has inspired you as an entrepreneur.
Elon Musk.
I love it already. I'm going to read some of these as well.
Oh, go for it.
Tony Mendoza, Yati Yadav, Bill Gates, Elon Musk, Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Dara and Dave Feldman. Thank you, Jack. Zach, Mark Cuban, Elon Musk is winning the race so far. Jeff Bezos, Bill Gates, Mark Cuban, Casey Neistat, Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Manny Koshbin, Bill Gates. Keep on writing them. Please, you know, if you haven't written them, put them in there. So now I'm going to ask you to write one or two words about why. Just one word, if you can do it. Why this entrepreneur inspired you.
Or what's one word that would describe them, right? That's inspiring. Actually,
that's right. Thank you.
So go ahead and just type that, right?
Hardworking, creative. Passionate, innovative, driven, makes mistakes and learns, so reflective, hardworking, loyal, determined, push past boundaries, perseverance, yes, opportunist. My dad, passionate and loyal, sympathetic and diligent. So it's interesting, a lot of different words here, but if you look at a lot of these words, these are virtues. These are things that are our character of who we are. And Dara wants to introduce us and kind of move in that direction a little bit and talk a little bit about what are virtues.
Thank you, baby.
So Dara,
all right.
Jump in.
So now it's your turn. Take a look at the list of these universal positive qualities of character. This is who you all are. This is actually the short list. There are over 300 that are common from all of humanity. But please rename your Zoom window by hovering over your name and put your first name and a strength virtue of yours.
If you're not familiar with that, you just hover over your name and you click on it. There's three dots in the upper right-hand corner. And there's a little drop down that says,
they're digital natives. We're the immigrants, honey. They got
I'll bet somebody out there didn't know it.
Or you can type it in the chat box.
Right.
All right. So just what's one of your strength virtues?
And if you knew it,
don't be humble, by the way. Okay. And
again, it doesn't have to be on this list, although you're welcome to use this list. We use another word that describes you as well.
Yep. So you can put it in the chat box or you can rename your window with your first name. Okay, and the virtue. And again, as Dave said, just you can hover over your name, click on it, and add it. So I see Brian is cooperation, and I think you all are being really discerning.
And there's and in the chat box, persistence, innovative, creative, optimism.
Now, here's the thing. I'm seeing the speech bubbles. I know many of you are looking at that list and going, nope, nope, I can't put that. Nope, nope, don't got that, right? You're so good at beating yourselves up. In fact, we all are. When we look through the lens of virtues, this is a strength-based perspective. And it's really part of our healing journey. So now keep going and give you, you know, you can continue to change your name and add your virtue or type it in the chat box. I want to give you just a quick history of the Virtues Project. So here's what's really exciting for me. You all have been so incredibly purposeful with these challenges. And I hope that you felt a difference by focusing on your virtues. But we're excited to let you know that each and every one of you is an integral part of a global grassroots movement. Woo! Celebrate, celebrate. Yeah. Yes, you. You all are leaders right now in this global grassroots movement. The Virtues Project, I'll give you a quick history, was founded about 31 years ago by a husband and a wife team of therapists, as you see on the screen, Dr. Dan Popoff and his wife, Linda Cavalin Popoff, and Linda's younger brother, who was a Disney Imagineer. And they were having brunch at the Empress Hotel one Easter, talking about how tragic it is that kids are killing each other. And they said, somebody ought to do something. And one of them said, why not us? So John quit his job at Disney, moved in with his sister and brother-in-law, and they took a summer of discernment. And they found through a Harvard study that the number one reason that youth ages 14 to 25 gave for randomly committing acts of murder. I'm actually going to ask you this question. What do you think is the reason that youth ages 14 to 25 randomly, not premeditated, randomly commit acts of murder? Go ahead and put it in the chat box. I'll give you 30 seconds. Anger could be, absolutely, built up rage. These are all good reasons. Loneliness, mental health struggles, jealousy, hate, sadness. Yes, it could be all of these, right? But now, drumroll, it's actually boredom. And I don't mean the boredom that you all might be experiencing right now, listening to two old people talk to you about virtues.
Hey, hey.
Self-discipline, right? But a lack of meaning and purpose. And we think about 31 years now, right? Where we are now, COVID, technology, all of the other things that prevents us, and especially young people, to know their inherent value. This is even more prevalent. And this gets to the mental health and well-being. So the founders with their psychology background said, you know, this is a spiritual issue, a spiritual illness. And they researched all of the cultures, oral traditions, and sacred texts of the world. And what they found that was common to all of humanity were the virtues. Knowing that you and me and everybody are all born with these virtues and potential, they thought, how can we awaken and strengthen them in our children? And they came up with five strategies: speaking the language, recognizing teachable moments instead of shaming and blaming, setting clear boundaries based on restorative justice, honoring the spirit, and the companioning process. a 7-step counseling technique to lead somebody to their own solution. And they self-published the family guide. And when Linda was on Oprah, which was somebody who you all respected, Oprah said of the family guide, it's the instruction manual that our kids didn't come with. Did you all come with instructions? I didn't think so. Neither did our kids who are 27 and 30. And now the Virtues Project is in over 140 countries, honored by the United Nations and endorsed by the Dalai Lama. And you, DECA, are going to help these virtues go viral.
So Virtues Matter is our company, and we are partners with Virtues Project. And we thought we'd have a little bit of fun here. We actually use the slide a lot. Dara has been doing the Virtues Project since she was, it's been about 15 years now. And when you hear how she acknowledges people and just integrates the virtues, it really is what it's all about. It really is about how to bring out the best in others using the virtues. I'm still in the baby path right now. It took me a little longer to find my way here. So we like to have some fun over here. And if you look at this, we have been working with the DECA folks. So Virtues Matter is one of several organizations that focuses on facilitation and taking the virtues and working in different industry sectors with different groups across the whole world, actually. So my background, as I said, was economic development. My patch has always been taking this to business right now. There's a couple of big movements right now. If you know the B Corporation and Benefit Corporation, conscious capitalism, impact investing, those are areas that I've always been really passionate about because I've always seen business as the avenue to make really dramatic change. Entrepreneurs, as you are all becoming and already are, have a way of really driving innovation into a number of different areas. So Dara has been focusing on education, working across a whole range of different particular areas. And one of the things that we have done is we've created a product called the Virtues Cards mobile app, which you actually have now. So we are entrepreneurs ourselves. We don't just work with entrepreneurs. And the Virtues Cards app is taking something that they created about 20 years ago and digitizing it and allowing a whole range of different decks to be put into a program where you can download full decks now and do things like what you're doing. And what you've done is incredibly innovative, taking these 12 missions and starting to integrate that. So we work with communities, we work with schools, we work with a whole range of different types of groups. And I want to leave a teaser before I hand back to Dara, is that one of the things that we're looking at doing is a new set of cards that we're going to upload. And I like to smile when I say this, but it's going to be a new deck of cards. And we've been talking with some folks about potentially private labeling. I know, I see the hands up there. It's like, this would be a partnership with DECA and an opportunity to bring those cards on, having you design those cards and have a role in them, and then also using them as a fundraiser for DECA. Woo-hoo! So we're going to talk a bit about more about that later, but now I want to jump into a virtues pick. So as I mentioned, there's many different ways of using the virtues. A virtues pick is a way that we go in for a deep connection. Did you want to?
So we've, thank you so much, Zach, for your willingness to be of service to read the card. We're going to model how to do a virtues pick, and it's something that you all can do with your family, with your friends, by yourself. And we chose this virtue because we feel it exemplifies you all. Zach, go ahead and read the front side or the left side of the card, please.
All right. Idealism is having a vision of what is possible and wanting to make a difference. It is caring passionately about what is meaningful in life. Idealists see things as they could be and have faith in the power of change. We put our principles into practice. We don't just accept the way things are. We dare to have big dreams and then act as if they are possible. Idealism doesn't mean that we are idle dreamers. Idle dreamers just wish things were different. Idealists do something to make things better.
And Olivia,
last sentence. We make the ideal real.
Thank you for your service of reading, Zach.
Yep. And Olivia, if you can read the back of the card. Sorry, I jumped ahead on that.
Of course. You see things as, and you say, why? But I dream things that never were, and I say, why not? George Bernard Shaw. The practice of idealism. I have a dream. I have a plan. I have faith in the highest possible outcome. I walk my talk. I persevere. I make a difference. I am thankful for the gift of idealism. It helps me realize my dreams.
Thank you for your helpful service reading that. So in a minute, Brian, I'm going to invite you to share how idealism resonated with you, what it made you think and feel. And as Brian's sharing, if any of you wish to put in the chat box how idealism speaks to you, please feel free to do so. Brian?
Awesome. Good morning, everyone. I hope everyone's doing well. All right. So when I read the card of idealism, I think one of the first things that came into my head was automatically everyone here, DECA members, and really just Innovate 2020. Because the way I saw it, I saw idealism integrated with innovation. Because when you innovate, you have a dream to take things to the next level. You're saying, why not? And that's what I see as innovation as. Like, why not? Why not do this? And having that dream of just going at it. And to me, that is the DECA community. You guys are here taking these opportunities, joining these keynote sessions, and taking your jab at it. Instead of just dreaming it, you're going, how am I going to get there? You and practicing, I have a plan. And you guys are going in with those resources and walking your talk. And that's idealism to me. From what I'm reading, it's like putting your practices and taking that dream you have in your head and going all the way. You're going full send. You're taking it. You're using your dream, and you're going to take innovation to a new level. And I think there's no better place than Innovate 2020 to realize your idealism and just take your dream and go for it.
Yeah. Well, Brian, first of all, I want to honor you for your optimism and hope and looking for the positive right now. And that goes back to what I was saying about entrepreneurs have that vision looking forward. But also your thoughtfulness, recognizing all your team members who are here as well. Because I know, you know, everyone's not on the front screen right now, but all of you are doing really amazing things. And we're just learning, doing so many good things to improve and better the world. So thank you for elevating everybody. And entrepreneurship is a guide for change.
Absolutely. All right, friends, estate change. Everybody rub your hands together. We've already been sitting too long. Rubbing, 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 getting some energy, rubbing, rubbing, rubbing. Feeling the heat. All right, now see if you can open it up and just feel the chi. And even if you can't, it's just a mindful moment. We're going to do another one called PBS. Pause, take a breath, and then exhale and smile. A light smile, not a cheesy or annoyed with me smile, because I'm going teacher on you. Whether you laugh at us or you laugh with us, it's still dopamine. Okay, so we're going to go into the power of language very quickly so that we can be reliable and end on time. Do you believe that power, that language can inspire or discourage? Everybody, right? So I want you to think of somebody who's stubborn, just one person. And I want you to say out loud, muted, at the top of your lungs, "You're so stubborn," three times, and notice where you feel that in your body. Are you ready? Here we go. One, two, three.
You're so stubborn.
You're so stubborn. You're so stubborn. Type in the chat box where you felt that. How many of you all felt it in your solar plexus? Or if you can show us, right? Headaches, I see. Maybe your necks. It didn't feel good, did it? So now we're going to rewind and we're going to reframe that stubbornness, because entrepreneurs, you need that, to the virtue of determination. Think of that same person, and this time say, "You're so determined," and notice where you feel it. Ready? One, two, three.
You're so determined.
You're so determined. You're so determined. Where'd you feel it now? In your heart. Absolutely. I see Holly pointing there, right? In your heart. Everything is energy, and what we focus on expands. And so when we can focus on the language of virtues, the virtue that we see exemplified and the evidence, that makes all the difference in the world. And so now we're going to move on to...
So we're going to move on to gratitude, which is one of the actual missions that was put in place here. So gratitude is one of those things also that just has a really big power in our lives. If we come from a place of gratitude and we appreciate what we have, it makes us better, happier people in general. And it actually changes the outcomes of situations. So we're going to introduce a real quick intro of your mission. And then we're going to show a few of the submissions that came in for gratitude. Just
and
a couple minutes.
We're super grateful to all of you all for participating.
This is just a small subset randomly selected.
Hey there, innovator. I just received a special mission from Virtues Matter. Our virtue is gratitude, which is the quality of being thankful, showing appreciation, and returning kindness. Let's take a look and see where gratitude will take us today. Here's what it says. Share the love. Choose someone with whom you want to show gratitude towards. Choose a virtue that you want to recognize them for, and share a virtue card with them as well as a message of gratitude. Submit a picture of you and the person you are showing gratitude towards, and please include a virtue card in your picture. I'm going to share the love by sharing the virtue of honesty with my friend Lily, because I appreciate it when she's honest because it really benefits our team. Share the love today, DECA.
All that I am, all that I see, all that I've been and all that I'll ever be is a blessing. It's so amazing and I'm grateful for it all, for it all. Grateful for it all.
You're the blessings every time I try to count. You're the lessons that I learn every time I turn around. You're the water when I'm burned every time I think I found everything I'm looking for. You're the sign saying stop to take a bow and keep moving forward and start looking towards your heart. It'll open all the doors and only then you'll start to hear the world singing chorus with your mind and heart aligned to purpose. Everything
all
will
that
feel gorgeous.
I am, all that I see.
So gratitude. So first of all, I want to extend gratitude for all of you for putting together some just wonderful videos and sharing gratitude to others. And you know, Dara and I have recognized the power of gratitude and appreciation. And we have launched a program which we're now working with DECA on called Share the Love. And LOVE is an acronym for Language of Virtues Everywhere, for Everyone, Every Day. Do you want to pull the slide up there a bit?
So
this is a program that's being embraced by a number of other groups, but we're really excited about DECA for what's going on with you guys, because we have some big ideas. We see you as a partner do some really cool things together about sharing a virtue from a deck. And for those of you who may have downloaded the deck, you may have a sample deck, but you can get full decks down below. There's actually 5 decks right now, and there are more coming. And you can download a full deck that has a whole list of the virtues, up to 100. And it's a 99 cents or a $1.99 one-time download. So it's a really powerful tool. And you can acknowledge people for the good that you see in them. Or you can acknowledge a business for the good that you see in them. Or a cause. You can really promote anything that uplifts positivity. And you can send it by text, social media. You can post it there with a hashtag. We've been using Share the Love, and a lot of people are. And you can use a Share the Love DECA as well to really start gaining some real momentum within your community. So there's going to be more coming out with that. We're working with a team of folks to really help scale this up. And, you know, we're looking forward to sharing the love with DECA. So thank you for all for what you're doing. So
here's your homework.
What can you do right now in lieu of Share the Love? Because we really think that practicing these virtues really does change your life. It is really remarkable. And I was a latecomer to the game here. We have a thing, and you can tell we like acronyms. One of our acronyms is the PLAN. And it's pretty simple. We can send this out to your team. Number one, pick daily. In the app, you have reminders, so you can actually schedule it for every day. So you can do a daily pick at a certain time every day. Number two, look for the good in yourself and others. Kind of reframe your thinking. Look at yourself in the positive ways, and that's what these virtues really help you do. So look at what you have as a strength virtue. Three, acknowledge and appreciate often. Just give somebody a look, a positive recognition for what you see in them, and you're going to be amazed at how they respond to you, but how you also feel at the same time. And then four, notice teachable moments. you know, you'll read a virtue and one day it'll be completely different from the next day because of where you are. So look at what it means to you, what sentence stands out to you, and what's going on in your life at that time. So that's the plan.
All right. Here, we're going to end with a magic trick in 1 minute. But here's our contact. It's either Dara@virtuesmatter.com or Dave@virtuesmatter.com. And we welcome you to reach out so that we can be of service in any way that we can. And so before we close, we'd like to end with a water trick. So young entrepreneurs, you all come into this world with all of the virtues in you and potential, with a whole lot of idealism. And then COVID happens. And maybe you're not able to go to school for your senior year. You're stuck on doing Zoom. There's so many different things that cloud who you are. Maybe you're bullied, made fun of, etc. And who you are gets clouded. However, when you remember to speak the language of virtues, you recognize teachable moments instead of shaming and blaming. You set clear boundaries based on restorative justice. You connect with one another. You do the plan. Pick daily, look for the good, acknowledge and notice. And especially, you share the love. Not only do you get back to the clarity of when you started, you are even stronger, fuller, more resilient entrepreneurs. It has been a joy and an honor to be in circle with you. We wish you all much joy, meaning, purpose, always and in always. And you have given Dave and me so much hope about our future.
Yep.
Because you are the change that we wish to see in the world. We love you all so very much.
Let's all give Dara and Dave a warm thank you in the chat. It has been a pleasure to listen and hear your knowledge.
Thank you. That's so kind of you. And even just one word about how you're feeling about our time together.
Part of we wanted to uplift everybody. So yeah, just how do you feel, especially if it's different than what you felt earlier?
I feel motivated right now. Being with you guys just fills my bucket so much that I feel like I just want to go change the world.
I appreciate
your guys' vision and your sharing, and I am thankful for you guys.
Thank you. And we're thankful for you as well, Zach, and your teams.
All right. Love you all so much. Are you kicking us out now?
It's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to always feel like I'm empty and there's nothing really.
Aw, thanks for showing the love, everybody. That would be fun. You could, take pictures of yourself. Share the love. Hey, you're beautiful, though. I'm looking for a way out. I find out how to tell you how I want to run away. I understand it always makes you feel a certain way. I find a balance in the middle of the chaos. Send me up, send me down. Oh, should we share the love for them?
Remember
walking in the
kiss?
Yeah. We're married. 27 years and I've nothing to show. Here, this kiss for you. Dove to the dark of the crow. Looking through the ways of the ones before me. Looking through the path of the young and lonely. So glad that you all are feeling motivated and positive. We are too. Thank you. It's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to always feel, feel like I'm empty and there's nothing. Thank you everybody for your helpful service, running tech, pulling this together,
doing the challenges. Danielle, for all your work. Too many people to shout out to, but we know all the people behind the scenes don't always get recognized, but do a lot of heavy lifting. So it's been a pleasure.
Hello, hello, let me tell you what it's like to be. All right, everybody, get up. You've been sitting. Are you waiting for us to leave? Okay, no. Then everybody get up and move. It's also World Kindness Week.
So is Chief Enthusiast Officer, is that appropriate? And I'm the Chief Everything Else Officer. Not only do I get an extra E, I got to keep this one together. Cut.
Cut. Can do the outtake.
Oh my goodness.
Listen, Dave's heart still in process. This is Dara's heart, totally refined. Just kidding. Has it snowed yet where you all are? Not yet?
They don't get much snow there.
Want to honor your creativity, everybody.
If we had more time, we would take you through our little menagerie of toys.
The virtues are the key to success, in case you're wondering. Okay, I'm done.